Hello all of you. Today we are going to the next practice sheet, that is P15. It is pin and bush type flexible coupling. As you can read here, pin and bush type flexible coupling. So we are going, we will be given detailed drawings of this particular coupling as usual, and then we have to assemble them and form the assembly. Now, as we have seen earlier, for preparing the assembly we are supposed to know the function of that particular assembly, and then keeping the function in mind, we have to think how these various parts, they can be assembled to form the final assembly which can perform a specific function. So for that we are making use of the dimensions, the material, the quantity, the shape, the function, all these things together we take into consideration, and then we assemble all these parts. Now first thing is, we should know what is the pin and bush coupling all about, what it does. So let's have a look at that first. We have not yet come across pin and bush coupling as to what it is. Basically, what is a coupling, that itself we are not yet aware of. So let's first start from that. What is a coupling? So now see here, I am going to draw one motor. So think about this as an electric motor. And once you give supply, then as you know, the shaft of the motor will start rotating. That means there is a power available here at the shaft. Certain RPM it is rotating. Now what happens is, there is a machine. So I am just drawing here a machine, which is represented just by a box. So now you will see that here there is a machine, here there is a motor. The machine has got a shaft like this, which we want to rotate. So once you rotate the shaft, then the machine will start functioning. And for rotating the shaft, you need a motor, which is also there. So this motor is suitable for this machine. Everything, power etc., is matching. Now the question is, how to transfer the power from this shaft to this shaft. So now at this stage, what is done is, here for connecting these two shafts, here a unit is fitted here. So whatever I have shown here in the form of a box, this unit which is shown here is a unit, is a device, or is an assembly whose function is to transfer power from this motor to this machine. Now how that happens, that is what is to be seen. How this power transmission takes place, how this box is a coupling, how it looks and how it functions, that is the next thing. So let me draw just the coupling now to explain how it functions. So now let us see how it works. So how this is done is, there is one shaft like this. So now I am drawing only the shaft. So this is a shaft which is coming from motor, and on this shaft here there is what is called as a coupling fitted. So the coupling is something which looks like this. So you can think of this as a disc. The disc has got these two diameters, one here and one here, and this disc is fitted to the coupling, to the shaft, with the help of a key. So I have drawn a key which indicates that this coupling is fitted to the shaft, so that when the shaft rotates, this coupling will also rotate. Now same thing on the other side here. There is another shaft, and we are fitting another coupling here, similar coupling here. So this fitted on the other side, and again here also there is a key. I am just representing, I am not drawing very exactly, just to indicate that shaft and coupling is connected to each other with the help of a key, so that when the shaft rotates, the coupling rotates, when the coupling rotates, the shaft rotates. So now the power is there at the shaft. From the shaft, through the key, the power goes to coupling and coupling starts rotating. Our job is to transfer the power from this shaft to this shaft. Now for this, once this coupling rotates, the power is here. Now this power should jump from here to here. Now how that is done is, between these two here, they are fitting one nut bolt. So I have drawn a bolt. So one bolt is put from here, and on this side you are putting a nut. So that means we are basically connecting these two flanges. The moment you connect the two flanges, now what happens, when this particular flange rotates, because of this bolt, the power will automatically get transmitted to this side. So this flange also will rotate, and because there is a key, the power will go from the flange through the key to the shaft, and finally this shaft becomes capable of rotating this shaft. So the power transmits from one shaft to another through key, through coupling, through bolt, through other coupling, through key to the shaft. Right? So this is the way the power transmission takes place in general, and I have shown you in a very, very brief way. In reality, there are many other things to be considered. Now, whatever I have drawn is in fact called as a rigid coupling. Rigid coupling in the sense, when the axis of this and the axis of this shaft are in perfectly one line, that time it is possible to do like this. And moreover, what is also done, which I have not shown, but what is also done is, the two surfaces I have shown with some gap. But for a rigid coupling, there is no gap. The one flange touches to the other flange, like this. So the two flanges, they are in contact, they are touching each other. Not only touching, but there is a small step here. So there is a step. So with the help of this step, the coupling is connected here and it is located also here. But then the power is not transmitted by this step, it is only for location. That means these two axes will be maintained in one line. The connection takes place by bolts and the power transmission also takes place by bolt. But this is a case of rigid coupling. This is a case of rigid coupling. Now what happens? When the two shafts, their axes are in one line like this, then only this is possible. But if the axes are not in one line, suppose there is some vibration here and there is some vibration here, that means the axis you cannot maintain in one line. In that case, this kind of rigid coupling will not work. It will not work. Then what we have to do is, we have to do some such thing so that even if these two axes are not in one line, they are vibrating, still you should be able to transmit the power. And in this situation, what is done is, first of all, you cannot locate them like this. That means we are keeping them separate. So as I had drawn earlier, these are the two flanges. They are not connected with each other. They are not touching each other. And because they are vibrating, because their axes are not in one line. And what is also done is, at this place here, there is no bolt, but there is a special pin fitted here. There is a special pin fitted here, which is meant for this purpose. Bolt was a standard bolt. Now there is a pin here, and this pin is surrounded here by a bush. So now what I am drawing here is a bush. Okay, so what I have drawn here is 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 bushes are there. So these 4 bushes, they are of rubber material. So they are flexible material. So now what happens? Everything else is same. So power comes from here, it goes on this side. But when it goes on this side, it goes through the bushes. And bushes are rubber bushes, that means they are capable of getting compressed. And because of that, any misalignment, any slight vibrations which are there, because of that, these two axes are not remaining in one line. So that slight movement, 1 or 2 mm here and there, that is taken care of by the absorption of these rubber bushes. So because the rubber bushes are getting absorbed, the power transmission can be easily carried out, even though the axes are not in one line. So this is the way pin and bush type flexible coupling works. This is a pin and bush type flexible coupling. Earlier coupling was a rigid coupling where the two axes were in one line. So having got some basic idea of what the flexible coupling is, now let us go and see what is given to us as an assignment, which is on the same topic, pin and bush type flexible. Okay, so now look here, I will take you here to show you what is a coupling. So as you see here, whatever it described, that is shown here in a proper drawing. So you can see here, this is, of course, I am showing you assembly. I am showing you the answer. This is what you have to draw. You will be given the detailed drawings, which I'll discuss later. Right now, this is your final task, final assembly like this. And this is same as what I have just now described, but this is drawn with a proper drawing. So you can see one shaft from the left side, let's say it is a motor shaft. Then there is a key here. Then on this key, there is a coupling fitted here. So what you see here is a coupling connected to the shaft with the help of a key. Now on the other side also there is a shaft. You can see there is a machine shaft. Now this machine shaft is also fitted with a coupling and with the help of a key. So on this side and this side, there is a shaft and a key and a coupling, shaft and a key and a coupling. Now for the connection purpose, as you see here, there is a part number 5, which you can see here, pin. So it is a special pin. Now this pin is fitted here. I'll just take you very close. So now you can have just a look at the connecting arrangement. So there is a pin here which has got a head, then the rest of the body. Now on this body there is a bush fitted here. You can see there is a single bush in this case. So this rubber bush is fitted here, and then this pin continues with another diameter here. Then after this diameter there is a threading, and at this threading a nut is fitted. That means first this bolt is fitted, the first on this bolt the bushes are fitted, then bush and bolt together they are fitted here, and then they are clamped from nut. That means this arrangement is already in place. Next, what happens, this coupling is brought from this side, and on this rubber bush this is getting fitted. So this part of the coupling which has got a hole, so this hole gets fitted around this bush, outside of the bush. So now what happens, this rubber bush is fitted between the coupling of this side and between the pin on this side. So between the pin and the coupling now there is a rubber bush and it is fitted here. So now what happens, if you recollect what was discussed sometimes back, what happens is when this shaft rotates, key rotates, coupling rotates, because of this bolt power goes to this side, because of the rubber bush the power gets transmitted to the other side through the rubber bush, which is capable of compressing, and then the power goes to the flange, and then through the flange, through the key, it goes to the other side, and thus the power gets transmitted. Okay, so whatever function we have discussed, that is clearly shown here by this assembly. So how many parts are required here? You require a shaft, quantity 2. So part number 3 here is a shaft, quantity 2, material MS. Then you require keys. So there are 2 keys, material, rather the name of the key is 4, part number is 4. So part number 4, key, material MS, quantity 2. So you require 2 such keys. Then there is a flange here. Now this flange and this flange, they are not same. So therefore, this is a flange which is called as number 2. So you can see left side flange number 2. On the right side, there is flange number 1, right side flange, material caster and quantity 1. So these are the 2 flanges on 2 sides. Then coming here, there is a part which is a pin, part number 5 from here to here. So part number 5 is a pin, material MS, quantity 4, because there are 4 such pins, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So at 90 degrees apart, that will be seen in the side view. So there are 4 such pins. So material number is 5, serial number 5, name is pin, material MS, quantity 4. Now outside the pin, there is a rubber bush which has got part number 7. So part number 7 bush, material is rubber, quantity 4. 4 pins, 4 bushes. And on this side for the same pin, there is a nut also. So part number 6 is a nut. Part number 6 is a nut, material MS, quantity 4. So these are all the different parts which are assembled to form this assembly. Now here their dimensions are shown. That is because it is a textbook's problem. It is an assembly shown in the textbook as a question, so that this is given as a question and you will be asked to draw the detailed drawings. You will be asked to draw the detailed drawings. But right now, for you, it is not so. For you, the detailed drawings are given and this is going to be your answer. So when this is answer, in fact, in any case, in the assembly drawing, the dimensions are never drawn. Here they are drawn. Here the dimensions are given because you, in some cases, this is given as a question so that students should be able to draw the detailed drawings. And for drawing the detailed drawings, students require dimensions. Therefore, these dimensions are given. But these dimensions are not for you. For you, the part dimensions are already given in the detailed drawings. So now let us go to detailed drawings and see what it is. So let me show you this drawing. I'll show you this drawing first. So this is a part drawing, and you can also see that this is part number 2, left side coupling part number 2. It looks like this. You can see how it is made up of. It has got one collar here, slide collar, so that you know nut will be covered by this collar, so that it is getting protected, so that there is no damage if the person is standing here and if the bolt is rotating at high speed, and if there is no cover like this, then there is a risk of accident. So for covering the bolt, there is a nut provided here. That is for the safety purpose. It is for the safety of the operator. This is not for the safety of the nut. Okay, we have to save the operator. Therefore, this projection is given here. So there are 4 such holes for this particular pin. Okay, and all the dimensions are given accordingly. You have to draw this to form the assembly. There is a keyway also shown, and you have to fit the keyway here. So you can see square key size is given, material MS quantity 2. So there are 2 such keys, one fitted on this and the other fitted on the other key. So part number 2 is shown, part number 4 which is a key which is shown, part number 3 which is a shaft, material MS quantity 2 which is also shown. So 3 parts are shown on this particular page. Similarly, now let us see the other set of drawings. So here you will see some more parts. This is part number 1, which is the should be right side flange. So this is the right side flange. This correction is a mistake. Right side flange, which is this side flange. So that is shown here again by all the required dimensions. You can see the holes are of a larger size because they should accommodate rubber bush here. So accordingly the diameter is shown here. So this is rubber bush, and in the side view is like this. There is some correction here in the figure. So the way it is drawn, it is not correct, but what is shown here is correct. So what is shown here is that this part is not like this. I'll just take you maybe more closer. So now just look here. Okay, now this is not there. So there is a hole here, the inside diameter is a hole, and the outside diameter has got a shape which is like this. And this is already there. So this is how the shape is going to be, and these lines, they are drawn so that they will pass from the center of the circle. So this is the way these lines will be drawn, and this everything is solid, but I have not drawn it properly here, which I will draw like this, and then there is a hole. This is how the shape is. So now you can see here what you have to see here is, right, I have to rub this drawing. So you can see here that this is a boss of the coupling. So the diameter, the thickness here is more for this part. There is a hole here. Then in this in between part here, everywhere else, the thickness is 16. The thickness is 16 everywhere else. And near the bush, the thickness is 25. So here it is 25. That means here, whatever I have shown just now, that is 25 around the bush. And rest of the place all over here, it is 16, which is thin. This part is thin. And this part only near the bush, it is thick because the bush has got a thickness which is, in fact, it is more than 25. As you now go back and see here, see 16 here and 25 here, and the bush is so much wide. So 25 plus 6, that is 31. That may be the length of the bush. So that is why to accommodate the bush, this extra length is given here, and some part of the bush is still outside. Okay, so that is what we have to think over and draw. Bush is shown here, the length of the bush is 31. Here this is 31. okay, inside diameter is 16, outside diameter is 28, and this is a rubber bush. Then there is a nut here, and here you can see there is a pin. This pin is shown like this. Pin is shown like this, and pin has got threading here, plain diameter here, 16 diameter here, and 20 diameter here. Is a head, and then all the details are given here. So this is how you will draw. The details are given to you. So one set of details here, then the other set of details is here like this, and after that you have to think over and draw the assembly, which is going to be this assembly. This is the assembly which you have to draw. Okay, so this is the work what we have to carry out as the assembly drawing.